Coach, would you talk about the defensive success that you had in particular in the first half, shut down what you did?
Yeah, we did a really good job. Thought we controlled the line of scrimmage really well, and credit to our defensive line. Freed up a lot of linebackers, and, you know, safeties coming downhill. So, you know, we came out hot, and we just didn't do a good job carrying that into the second half.
Steve and Rob.
Just how much of an impact was the weather just overall? How the Bulls have played in those conditions? And can you remember a game having played in those types of conditions before with swirling and wind and rain?
Yeah, no, I don't ever remember playing a game like that. I mean, that thing was, it was monsoon out there. But, I mean, they're playing in it too. So, you know, whatever we got to deal with, they got to deal with too. So just, that's all you got to think about. I mean, it doesn't, you just can't let it affect you.
Just what's this week been like? Well, is it a relief to play a football game today and sort of put all that stuff outside?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that's why, you know, that's why we do it. We do it to play on Saturday. Not for the drama and everything behind it. You know, we did just kind of with our brothers and play, and, you know, play for them. So it was a good, it was a good break.
How tough was the week? Was it tough?
Yeah, it was tough. I mean, anytime you lose somebody, lose your head coach, it's going to be tough. But, I mean, we got to bounce back, you know. There's nothing, I mean, that's life. I mean, you got to come back, I mean, head forward.
How much of an impact was the field position, the turnovers or the turnover on downs?
Yeah, that's big. I mean, field position is key. Whenever you give them a short field, you know, they're likely going to score. But, I mean, we don't look at that as a defense. We don't look at that. I mean, our job is to keep them out of the end zone, you know, keep the points off the board. But, I mean, that does, I mean, especially in those conditions, you know, when they're running the ball and giving them a short field.
Brian?
I think they threw the ball twice in the second half. Part of that, I'm sure, was due to weather. But what did they do run game-wise in the second half? They gave you guys problems that you seemed to have a handle on in the first half.
Different personnel, you know, they're coming out in 23 personnel, 22 personnel, you know, two tight ends, three running backs type deal. Just loading the box, and then, I mean, they do a good job with their shifts and their trades, and so just kind of like taking your eyes off of who you're supposed to be looking at. So I think that was really, they got into more shifts and trades and more jet motions in the second half.
Blake, for Colby and Kendall, both be either one, just the emotions of knowing that the Bowl hopes are now over after tonight's loss.
Yeah, it hurts. I mean, we wanted to get that bowl game. You know, we really want to finish the season out right, so that hurts. But I mean, you gotta look past it because we're playing Vanderbilt on Saturday, and that's you know, that's the biggest thing we're looking at. That loss last year, then that one hurt. We're definitely gonna have motivation for him.
Patrick,
Kendall, was it maybe I don't want to say a relief, but how excited were you guys to get out and finally play a game after the past 6 days?
Yeah, anytime you know you get to go on the football field, you can forget about all the off-the-field stuff. You know, we're playing for one another. We're playing for all our brothers in that locker room. We're playing for all the seniors. So it's nice to go out there and play the sport you all love.
Steve?
For Kendall, I mean, with the bowl bit out of the picture now, what do you use as motivation for this last week to try to finish the season the way y'all want?
Well, we know how we felt, you know, after the game last year, and we don't want that feeling again.
Ben.
Kendall, it looked like you were kind of waiting until the last possible second when LSU would line up on which side, where to look for you to line up. Talk about your thinking there and how you think that worked.
Yeah, you know, all week we, you know, LSU does a bunch of shifts, trades, and motions. And depending on that is where I line up. So, you know, Jump did a good job and telling me where to line up. And for the most part, I think we did a good job getting down, getting set, ready to go.
For Kendall, y'all shut them down. They had a single first down in the first quarter, maybe 9 rushing yards. How were you able to be so successful early on, and what changed the rest of the way? They were able to run the ball a little more effectively?
We knew we wanted to come out with a certain type of energy, you know, to help everybody on the team, to help our offense, help our special teams out, and to go out there and get those 3 and outs in the first couple series of the game, got the momentum going. I don't think we kept the same energy going on. We caught some bad breaks, but it's football, and you've got to be able to help your offense out in bad situations.
Rob?
Colton, LSU had some success with those speed sweeps, and they were using the running back, Williams, to do it. Why did they have success with those speed sweeps?
Yeah, I just don't think we set the edge very well. You know, we got to turn this ball back in, and because when you let it get to the outside, you're just playing with one or two guys, or as if you turn it in, you know, you're playing with your old defense. So I think that was, you know, that was pretty crucial for those plays.
Danny?
Kendall, you've been here 5 years now. You're about to go through your last week as a Tennessee football player. How do you handle the motions versus getting ready to play an SEC team like that?
I'll handle that after the game's over. You know, we got one more game to play. And, it's a state rival. But, you know, whatever you know happens after the game, I'll handle that there. But we got one more game.
Patrick.
For either of y'all, have y'all ever played a game even in high school that was as dark as it was to start the second half? I know some of the lights went out.
Not dark, but I played a game in high school. It was raining about that much. I mean, it's fun. You know, it's fun to play, you know, weather like that. You know, as a little kid, you always wanted to play in the rain for whatever reason. It was cool.
Any more questions? All right, thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Appreciate y'all.